How's it going, guys? I'm KRIMH, and this is another episode of KRIMH's Randomness. A new episode means a new adventure, and this one is quite a unique one. I just packed my pedals and my practice pads, and I'm going to France, to the city of Nantes. I got invited to take part in a scientific study about double bass drumming, and in particular, the ankle motion. I'm gonna meet Aurélie and the team of Drums Biomech. She's a French drummer, scientist, and engineer, and she tries to figure out in a sports lab under scientific condition how the ankle motion works. Which muscle groups are activated? Is it dangerous to do? Might there be any injuries involved with that? Because we still don't fully understand how it works. So I'm really looking forward to this study and to the final report, which will take a little bit until, you know, all the experiments are over. If you want to know how this goes, and if you're interested as well, how this whole process looked like, stay tuned. But I'm flying now to Nantes. Let's go.
Nice to meet you.
Karim.
Yeah, really.
So yeah, I did the engineering studies. So it was very generic topics, but I wanted to do biomedical studies. I went to Montreal and I did 3 years there to study biomedical engineering and more specifically biomechanics.
Biomechanics,
which is, the mechanics of the human body. I worked with kids with pathologies. So there were children who have cerebral palsy. So I did a few years in the medical topics. And then I came to Nantes, where I worked at the hospital for 5 years. So same topics, but it was both children and also adults. And then I had the job in Nantes University. And so it's great because I can work with athletes, very high athletes, in very specific sports.
Perfect.
Like rowing, cycling, fencing.
You know, I was in a sports school for 8 years, so
yeah.
Doing like sports high school, doing all kinds of different sports, and of course also learning about the body and biomechanics and that kind of stuff.
Nice.
So for me it has always been fascinating, and then having the chance to be in a lab and of course specifically for drumming, check everything, that's I was waiting for that. I was waiting for someone to finally do it.
That's great.
And you're the one, so that's super cool.
Yeah, thanks, it's great. The project has received a lot of attention and positive feedback, so I'm really happy about that. It's crazy.
Well, I cannot wait to get some senses for myself and try some things out. Thank you very much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
So this is the lab, and I have set up already this little station here. We're using not the foot blaster pad because I forgot the triggers to put on my pedals, shame on me, and we need to record the signal, so we use just the e-drum set pad, but yeah, I'm already in my sexy swimming pants, ready for the sensors.
So in the next hours, there will be several steps. So the first one, you will be over here, and we will do an ultrasound of your soleus muscle. So it's a muscle that we have within the calf, over here. So it's like you have 3 different muscles in the calf. You have the 2 gastrocnemius and the soleus, which is beneath, which is the largest muscle of the triceps surae. So it's a huge muscle. It allows you to keep standing, to walk, to run. So it's very powerful muscle. And since when you are drumming, you are sitting, actually the gastrocnemius don't have like the necessary length to produce powerful strength. So what we did, like our hypothesis is that the soleus is actually the main muscle involved during the ankle technique. And it's been verified doing ultrasound because we did see that the gastrocnemius muscle did not contract during the ankle technique, whereas the soleus muscle had a stronger activation. So Rémi, who is my student for the experiment, he will do an ultrasound of your muscle to be sure to find it, to find the perfect position for the probe, which will be attached to your muscle during the experiment. So you will be doing the ankle technique, and we will see the muscle contracting and relaxing during the motion. Rémi will electrocute you.
I heard about that. I will have some electroshock happening.
We are trying to do is stimulate the nerve to be able to measure the delay from which the nerve stimulation is sensed by your body and your muscle is responding by doing a slight contraction. So when Rémi will be sending the stimulation, we will see like a really slow movement, which is actually the response of your muscle to the stimulation. So that will give us the delay, which is mainly about 40 milliseconds. And this delay, we will measure and compare to what you are doing during the ankle technique to verify if the movement is indeed produced by a reflex loop. Here is the limit of the skin. You have 1 centimeter of depth, 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters. Here you have an adipose layer, fat. Yeah. And then you have the muscles. So the muscles, here Rémi is on the soleus muscle. So it's actually the muscle we are interested in. And here you can see your muscle fibers. They have an angle between the two upper neuroses, like that. And if you gently lift your foot like that, you... Yeah, exactly. So you can see the muscle fibers contracting. So they contract, which means they pull, they are pulling each side like that. You have the muscle, which is an elastic, and then you have the tendon, which are like ropes, because they are very stiff. And when the muscle fibers contract, they shorten and they pull on both sides the muscle on which they are attached. So Rémi is putting the anode and cathode. So it will be the two electrodes, and between them, the current, the electric current will go straight. And since you have the tibial nerve, so we are looking for the nerve which innervates the soleus muscle, and it goes just past the knee over here and to the soleus. And so Rémi will be finding it with the electrodes just below the knee here, and finding it by sending little currents. He will be increasing the intensity just slowly, and trying to find the reflex that we want, so the contraction of the soleus muscle. It can be a bit long, especially the...
There we are! Now we have it!
So yeah, this is great. You can see the... Okay, it's a M answer. It means that the intensity was a bit high, and we have the M reflex, the M answer wave, and not the H reflex. So we need to slow a bit the intensity, and we will have the H. The H is here, but it's too small for us. We want to have a huge one to be able to detect the...
Definitely felt that.
Yeah.
And it moved.
It means that it's too high if we have the M wave. So we will slow a bit the intensity, but it's the right place.
Yeah. Ah!
Yes!
Now
nice!
We have it.
Vous continuez que ça pendant 15 minutes avec les bras et voilà, ça fait un peu d'enfant.
All the drummers that we did in experiment, I think only one did not use the tibialis anterior, but everyone does. But it's used as the soleus, meaning it's just a small activation, deactivation. It's a muscle that is that tires very fast. So if you have an activation of the tibialis anterior at the same time of your activation of your soleus muscle, then it creates what we call coactivation. And that is when you feel your tibial burning. Every drummer uses both the soleus to produce the movement, and when the bat comes back, everyone uses his tibialis anterior also.
So it's both which you
need? It's both the muscles who are working, but they are working together. Whenever you want. Do you want to try 230? On la garde quand
Now the drumming is done and we have to do one more test. It's like what, maximum strength test?
Yeah.
For certain
maximal
muscle groups?
Maximal voluntary contraction, isometric contraction. So it means
okay.
that you will be blocked by straps.
Mm-hmm.
You will force the maximal, so it's voluntary activation, and we will try to do the maximal. So you will hear us crying and like shouting at the
power.
Loudest. Because it's been proven in the literature that to have a maximal voluntary contraction, we need to shout and we need to encourage the participant, because if we just do, okay, 3, 2, 1,
yeah.
go, the person will force, but not at its maximum.
Now comes the torture part.
3, 2, 1, allez, 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 allez. Okay.
Allez. We did it. Let's go. So this journey comes to an end. It was very interesting and very informative to be part of this double bass studies. I cannot wait till I get the data back. It will take some time to go through all of that. Probably a couple of months until we have some results. But I want to say a big thank you to Aurélie, her team and her partner, for hosting me, for taking care of me, also organizing the masterclass and just being awesome people. So thank you very much. And hope you guys enjoyed this episode. And as always, thank you very much for watching. And I'm gonna see you in the next one. So I'm flying back home. See you.